So, moving straight away to question number 5 from exercise 4.3. In a class test, the sum of Shefali's marks in mathematics and English is 30. So, if the marks in mathematics is X, then the marks in English is 30 minus X, because on adding these marks, we should get 30. So, let the marks in maths be X and then the marks in English is 30 minus X. The question doesn't end here. Continuing, they say, if she had scored 2 marks more in maths, that is 2 marks more in maths means x plus 2 in maths, and 3 marks less in English, that is 30 minus x minus 3 in English. So 30 minus x minus 3 is 27 minus x. So 2 marks more in maths and 3 marks less in English. If she had scored this much, then the product of the marks would have been equal to 210. So, taking the product, x plus 2 into 27 minus x is equal to 210. Opening the brackets, x into 27, 27x, x into minus x, minus x square, 2 into 27 plus 54, plus into minus minus, 2 into x, 2x is equal to 210. So, 27x minus 2x is 25x. Rewriting, minus x square plus 25x plus 54 is equal to 210. On transposing, we get the equation of the form x square minus 25x plus 156 is equal to 0. So now, using the quadratic formula, let us solve for x and then we will find the marks that Shefali scored. The question is to find the marks in two subjects. So a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 25, and c is equal to 156. So we know the quadratic formula, x is equal to minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So x is equal to minus b minus of minus 25 plus or minus under root minus 25 whole square minus 4 into 1 into 156 whole divided by 2 into 1. So this is equal to minus into minus plus 25 plus or minus under root 625 minus 4 into 156. 4 6 are 24, 2 carry, 4 5 are 20, 2 2, 4 1 are 4, plus 2 6, 6 24 whole divided by 2. So now this implies 25 plus or minus 625 minus 624 is square root of 1 whole divided by 2. So these are the required roots. Now let us separate the roots as we did before. X is equal to 25 plus 1 by 2 and x is equal to 25 minus 1 by 2. So x is the marks that Shefali scored in mathematics. So now simplifying, we get 25 plus 1, 26, 26 by 2, 13, and x equal to 25 minus 1, 24 by 2, 12. So both the numbers are positive, both the solutions are positive. So both of them are a possible solution for the marks that Shefali scored. So if her score in math is 13, then 30 minus x, which is equal to 30 minus 13, which is equal to 17, is the marks of English. This is case 1. Now case 2, when x is 12, if marks in math or maths is 12, then following the same procedure, 30 minus 12 is equal to 18 is the marks of English. So, these two are the possible solution for the solutions for the given question. If x is 13, then 30 minus x is 17, and if x is 12, then 30 minus 12 is 18. So this is the required solution. In the sixth question, the diagonal of a rectangular field is 60 meters more than the shorter side. So in a rectangle, we have two sides. One is length and the another is breadth. So shorter side of the both is the breadth. So if B is equal to x, or breadth of the rectangular field is x meters, then the question says that the diagonal of the rectangular field is 60 meters more. So that means x plus 60. So the length of the diagonal is x plus 60 meters. And if the other side, or if the longer side, is 30 meters more than the shorter side. The longer side is the length. So this implies length is x plus 30. 30 meters more than the shorter side. B is equal to x. So then find the sides of the field. We have to find the sides of the field. If you can see, this diagonal with the other two sides of the rectangular field forms a right angled triangle. So using Pythagoras theorem, we get x plus 60 whole square is equal to x square plus x plus 30 whole square. This is the hypotenuse. These are the base and the altitudes of the right angle triangle. So x plus 60 whole square can be on opening the brackets or by using the identity, we get x square plus 120x plus 3600 is equal to x square plus, opening the brackets on the second term, x square plus 60x plus 900. So transposing complete RHS to the LHS, we get x square plus 120x plus 3600. X square plus x square, 2x square. On transposing, it will be minus 2x square. 60 plus 60x will become minus 60x, and plus 900 will be minus 900 is equal to 0. On simplification, we get x square minus 2x square, it is minus x square. 120x minus 60x is plus 60x. 3600 minus 900 will be plus 2700 is equal to 0. So on multiplying the whole equation by minus sign, we get x square minus 60x minus 2700 is equal to 0. So now we have our values of A, B and C in the quadratic equation, and now we will solve the equation for x and then find length and breadth of the rectangular field. So now A is equal to 1, B is equal to minus 60 and C is equal to minus 2700. We know that x is equal to minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So substituting the values of a, b and c, we get minus b is minus of minus 60 plus or minus under root minus 60 whole square, that is b square, plus 4 into 1 into c, that is b square minus 4 into 1 into c, that is minus 2700 divided by 2 into 1. So this is equal to minus of minus plus 60 plus or minus under root 60 square is 3600 minus 4 into 2700, 4 zeros are 0, 4 sevens are 28, 8 to 4 to 8 to 10,800. Here it is minus into minus plus whole divided by 2. So this is equal to 60 plus or minus under root 0 on adding 108 plus 36, which is equal to 144. So it is 14,400 whole divided by 2. We know that 144 is square of 12. 144 is square of 12, and the 100 in front of that is a square of 10. So I can write it down as 60 plus or minus under root 12 into 10. It is 12 square into 10 square divided by 2. So on opening the square root, on getting rid of the square root, we get 60 plus or minus 12 into 10, that is 120 by 2. So our values of x will be, x is equal to 60 plus 120 by 2, and x is equal to 60 minus 120 by 2. So this implies x is equal to 60 plus 120, 180 by 2, that is 90 meters, and x is equal to 60 minus 120, which is minus 60 by 2, which is minus 30 meters. We know that the dimensions or the sides of any planar figures or geometrical figures can never be negative. So we can discard x is equal to minus 30. So the breadth, therefore, the breadth of the field is 90 meters. So now the length, we need to find both the sides. So we know that length is equal to 30 plus x, which is equal to 30 plus 90, which is equal to 120 meters. So this is the required solution, or these are the required dimensions of the field. So now moving on to the seventh question. The difference of squares of two numbers is 180. The square of the smaller number is 8 times the larger number. Find the numbers. If the larger number, is x, then they have told us that the smaller number is 8 times the square of the smaller number is 8 times that of the larger number. So that means square of small number is 8 times x. The square is 8 times x. So then they also told us that the difference of squares of two numbers, that means squaring the larger number, it is x square. Obviously the square of larger number is bigger. So the difference, x square minus 8x, that is the square of smaller number. Square of some smaller number is 8x, is equal to 180. So rewriting the equation, we get x square minus 8x minus 180 is equal to 0. Now this is our quadratic equation. Let's solve it. A is equal to 1, B is equal to minus 8, and C is equal to minus 180. So x is equal to, as we know, minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So now putting the values, minus of minus 8 plus or minus under root minus 8 whole square minus 4 into 1 into minus 180 whole divided by 2 into 1. So this is equal to minus of minus plus 8 plus or minus under root minus 8 whole squared is 64 minus into minus plus 4 into 180. 4 zeros are 0, 4 ones are 4 is 4, so 4 into 180. 4 zeros are 0, 4 eights are 32, 2, 3, 4 ones are 4 plus 3, 7, 7, 20 whole divided by 2. So this is equal to 8 plus or minus under root 784 divided by 2. So we know that square root of 784 is 28. So we get x is equal to 8 plus or minus 28 by 2. Now separating the roots of the equation, we get x is equal to 8 plus 28 by 2 and x is equal to 8 minus 28 by 2. 8 plus 28 is 36, 36 by 2 is 18 and 8 minus 28 is minus 20, minus 20 by 2 is minus 10. So, they are not specified that the given numbers are positive numbers or negative numbers. So, both the roots will do well with our solution. So, first case 1, if larger number, that is x is equal to 18, then the smaller number, is under root of 8 into 18. It is under root of 8 into 18 because the bigger number is 8 times the bigger number into 8 is square of the smaller number. So this implies the smaller number is 8 into 18. So it is 2 cube into 2 into 3 square. So which is equal to under root 2 raised to 4 into 3 raised to 2, which is equal to 2 square into 3, which is 4 threes are 12. If the bigger number is 18, then the smaller number is 12. Also, now the second case we have, if x equal to minus 10, x is equal to minus 10, we can discard x is equal to minus 10 from our solutions because there is no square root for negative numbers. The square roots are imaginary. Is invalid. So the two numbers are 12 and 18. This is the required solution. In the 8th question, a train travels 360 kilometers at a uniform speed. If the speed had been 5 kilometers per hour more, it would have taken 1 hour less for the same journey. Find the speed of the train. So, since we have to find the speed of the train, let speed of train be x. So, now the train travels a distance is equal to 360 kilometers. Then, the time taken t is equal to 360 by x. This is the first case. Okay, it travels 360 kilometers at a speed of x kilometer per hour. Then the time taken is t, which is equal to 360 by x. So also they have also told that if the speed of the train had been 5 kilometer per hour more. So if speed was 5 km per hour more, then the time taken for the journey would have been 1 hour less. So, if the time taken for the journey is t minus 1, for the same distance, that is 360 km, then the speed was x plus 5. This is the second equation. Subtract 1 and 2. Subtracting 1 and 2, we get t minus of t minus 1 is equal to 360 by x minus 360 by x plus 5. So here t minus t cancels out. What remains outside is 1 is equal to 360 by x minus 360 by x plus 5. So we are familiar with these kinds of equations. We will directly take the LCM. We get 1 is equal to 360 common. So, into the brackets we have x plus 5 minus x. And on the denominator we have x into x plus 5. X minus x cancels each other. So, 1 is equal to 360 into 5 by x square plus 5x. So, now transposing we get x square plus 5x is equal to 5 0 is a 0, 5 6 is a 30, 3 carry, 5 3 is a 15, 3 1800. So on transposing once again, we get this implies x square plus 5x minus 1800 is equal to 0 is our required quadratic equation. So now let us find the speed. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 5, and C is equal to minus 1800. So putting in the formula, we get minus 5, because minus B minus 5 plus or minus 5 square minus 4 into 1 into minus 1800 divided by 2 into 1, which is equal to minus 5 plus or minus under root 5 square is 25 minus into minus plus 4 zeros are 0, 4 zeros are 0, 4 8s are 32, 2 3, 4 3 carry, 4 1s are 4, plus 3 7200, whole divided by 2 1s are 2. So this is equal to minus 5 plus or minus under root 7225 divided by 2. So we know that square root of 7225 is 85. So minus 5 plus or minus 85 by 2. X is equal to, these are the roots. Now separating them, x is equal to minus of minus 5 plus 85 by 2. And x is equal to minus 5 minus 85 by 2. So x is equal to minus 5 plus 85, 80. 80 by 2 is 40 kilometer per hour. And on the other side, we get x is equal to minus 90 by 2, which is minus 45. Since we know that we are measuring speed, x is the value of speed, then it can never be negative. So the negative solution of the equation can be discarded. So our required solution is x is equal to 40 kilometer per hour. Therefore, the speed of the train is 40 kilometer per hour. This is the solution. In the ninth question, two water taps together can fill a tank in 9 3x8 hours. The tap of larger diameter takes 10 hours less than the smaller one to fill the tank separately. Find the time in which each tap can separately fill the tank. So here, to solve this, let the time taken by smaller tap be x. It be x. And they have told us that the tap of the larger diameter takes 10 hours less than the smaller one. So that means the time taken by the larger tap, then the time taken by larger tap is x minus 10 hours. This is hours, because the tap of larger diameter takes 10 hours less to fill the tank individually. That is less 10 hours less than the smaller tap. So if smaller tap takes x hours, then the larger will take x minus 10 hours individually. Therefore, part of tank filled by smaller tap in 1 hour is 1 by x. And similarly for larger tap it is 1 by x minus 10. Together they take 9 3 by 8 hours, which is equal to On simplifying this mixed fraction or converting it into improper fraction, we get 8 9s are 72, 72. 72 plus 3 is 75 by 8 hours. So using all the three informations, now we get 1 by x plus 1 by x minus 10 is equal to 8 by 75. We are taking the reciprocal because we are considering the amount of tank filled in 1 hour. So we are taking the reciprocals. Now we know these kinds of equations can be converted into quadratic equations by taking LCM and simplifying. So to do that, this implies LCM is x into x minus 10. Here x minus 10 is missing, x minus 10 plus here x is missing plus x is equal to 8 by 75. So this implies x plus x, 2x minus 10 by x into x minus 10 is equal to 8 by 75. So now on cross multiplying, we get this implies 75 into 2x minus 10 is equal to 8 into x, x square minus 10x. So this implies 75 into 2, it is 150x minus 75 into 10, it is 750, which is equal to 8x square minus 80x. So now transposing LHS to the RHS, we get 8x square minus 80x minus 150x plus 750 is equal to 0. So now this implies 8x square minus 180 minus 150, it is equal to minus 230x plus 750 is equal to 0. We can further simplify this equation by dividing it by 2. So we get 8 by 2, 4x square minus 230 by 2. 2 ones are carry 1, 2 fives are 115x plus 750 by 2, 2 threes are, 2 sevens are, and 2 fives are, which is equal to 0. So now we have our quadratic equation where a is equal to 4, b is equal to minus 115 and c is equal to 375. So our quadratic formula, we have x is equal to minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So this is equal to, substituting the values, we get minus into minus 115 plus or minus under root 115 minus 115 whole square minus 4 into minus 4 into a is 4 into 375 whole divided by 2 into 4 because 2 a is 4. So now calculating and substituting all the values, we get minus into minus plus 115 plus or minus under root 115 square is equal to 13,225 minus 4 fours are 16, 16 into 375 is equal to 6,000 whole divided by 8. So now further simplifying, 115 plus or minus 13,225 minus 6,000 is equal to 7,225 whole divided by 8. So now this is further equal to 115. Square root of 7,225 is 85 divided by 8. So now these are our roots. Splitting them apart, x is equal to 115 plus 85 by 8 and x is equal to 115 minus 85 by 8. So we get x is equal to, simplification, we get x is equal to 115 plus 85. 550 carry 1, 81910 carry 1, 112 divided by 8. And on the other hand, we have 5 minus 5, 0, and 11 minus 8, 30, 30 by 8. This can be further simplified as 8 ones are 25 za. So time taken by the smaller tap to fill the tank is, one solution is 25 hours and the second solution is 30 by 8 hours. Since we got two solutions, now we have to check which one of them is the proper solution. So case 1. Case 1, when x is equal to 25 hours. When x is 25 hours, then the time taken by the larger tap will be x minus 10, which is equal to 25, which is equal to 25 minus 10, which is equal to 15 hours. This is the time taken by the larger pipe. Then we have case 2, in which x is equal to 30 by 8 hours. And 30 by 8 hours, when simplification, we get it is equal to 3.75 hours. So x minus 10 is equal to 3.75 minus 10, which is less than 0, which is a negative number. So since time cannot be negative, our answer will be the time taken by the smaller pipe is 25 hours, and the larger pipe is 15 hours. This is the required solution for the 9th question. Now we have, in the 10th question, an express train takes 1 hour less than a passenger train to travel 130 km between Mysore and Bangalore without taking consideration the time they stop at intermediate stations. If the average speeds of the express train is 11 km per hour more than that of the passenger train, find the average speed of the two trains. So now here, let us consider average speed of the passenger train. The passenger train will have more stops and it will move more slowly. So let the average speed of the passenger train be x. If the average speed of the passenger train is x, then average speed of express train. They have told us that the average speed of express train is 11 km per hour more than that of the passenger train. Then the average speed of the express train is x plus 11 km per hour. This is the required speed. So now they have also told us that the express train takes 1 hour less than the passenger train to travel 132 km. So the distance is 132 km. So now time taken by the passenger train is distance, that is 132 divided by its average speed x. That this is the time taken by the passenger train. And similarly, time taken by the express train TE is equal to the same distance, 132 km, but here and its average speed is x plus 11 km per hour. So these are the time taken. Also, they have told us that the time taken by the express train is 1 hour less than time taken by the time taken by the passenger train. That means time taken by the express train is equal to time taken by the passenger train minus 1. If the passenger train takes 10 hours, that means 1 hour less. 10 minus 1, 9 hours. Say, that is some example I'm just giving you. It is not the answer. So, time taken by express train is equal to TP minus 1. So, substitute the values. T is 132 by x plus 11, which is equal to TP is 132 by x minus 1. So, now we can convert it into an quadratic equation by taking LCM and transposing things. So, here transposing to the LHS, we get 132 by x plus 11 minus 132 by x is equal to minus 1. So this implies 132 by taking the LCM x into x plus 11, 132 common, taking it out, we get x minus 11, because on cross multiplying and opening the brackets, plus into minus, it will become minus 11, which is equal to minus 1. So now cross multiplying once again or transposing the denominator to the RHS, we get 132, x minus x is 0, 132 into minus 11 is equal to minus 1 into x, x square plus x into 11, 11x. So now this is equal to 130 into minus 11. So plus into minus, we get minus, and 130 into 11 is equal to minus 1452, which is equal to minus into x square minus into plus 11x minus 11x. Transposing everything to LHS, we get x square plus 11x minus 1452 is equal to 0. This is our required quadratic equation. Now let us apply our quadratic formula. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 11, and C is equal to minus 1452. So our formula is x is equal to minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So the substituting the values of a, b and c, minus 11 plus or minus under root 11 square minus 4 into 1 into minus 1452 divided by 2 into 1. So this is equal to minus 11 plus or minus under root 11 square is 121 minus into minus plus 4 into 1, 4 ones are 4, 4 into 1452 is equal to 5808 whole divided by 2 ones are 2. So this is equal to minus 11 plus or minus under root 121 plus 5808 is equal to 5929 divided by 2. Now finding the square root. So we know that the square root of 5929 is 77. So x is equal to minus 11 plus or minus 77 divided by 2. So separating the factors, we get x is equal to minus 11 plus 77 by 2, and x is equal to minus 11 minus 77 by 2. So this is equal to minus 11 plus 77 is 66 by 2, and on the other hand, here we get minus 11 minus 77 is minus 88 by 2. 2 ones are 2, 44s are, which is equal to minus 44, and here the same thing, 2 ones are 33s are. 233s are. So x equal to 33 and x is equal to minus 44 are the two solutions for our quadratic equation. But we had assumed that x was the average speed of the passenger train, and as we know that speed cannot be equal to negative number, any negative number, speed cannot be negative. So x is equal to 33 is our solution, required solution. Therefore, the average speed ऑफ पैसेंजर ट्रेन इज 33 किलोमीटर्स पर आवर. देयरफॉर द एवरेज स्पीड ऑफ एक्सप्रेस ट्रेन इज, we had assumed it to be equal to x plus 11, which is equal to 33 plus 11, which is equal to 44 kilometer per hour. This is the solution to the 10th question. In the 11th question, sum of the areas of two squares is 468 meter square. If the difference of their perimeters is 24 meter, find the sides of the two squares. So here we will be using two variables for simplification purposes, but we'll be solving the equation with one variable only. So let us see how we'll do it. So first thing is let side of one square be x meters. X meters because they are told us that the sum of the areas is 468 meter square. It is in meters. And side of other square be y meters. So the sides are x meter and y meter. Then the perimeters, they are told us that the difference of their perimeters is 24 meter. That means perimeter of first square is 4x minus 4y. The difference of their perimeters, this implies 4x minus 4y is equal to 24. So this implies 4, 6. Dividing whole thing by 4, we get x minus y is equal to 6. So this implies x is equal to 6 plus y. Name this as equation 1. Now they also told us that sum of the areas of the two squares is 468 meters. So by the information on the areas we get, we also know that x square is the area of the first square plus y square is equal to 468. From equation 1 we have x is equal to 6 plus y. So we'll replace x square by 6 plus y whole square plus y square is equal to 468. So now this implies, opening the brackets, we get 36 plus 12y plus y square, opening the brackets, these three terms, and then we have plus y square is equal to 468. So on simplification, we get 36 plus 12y plus 2y square is equal to 468. Divide the whole equation by 2, we get 18 plus 6y, 36 by 2, 18, 12 by 2, 6 plus y square is equal to 4 by 2, 2, 3, 4, 234. So now transposing, we get y square plus 6y plus 18 minus 234 is equal to 0. So this implies y square plus 6y minus 216 is equal to 0. So now we got our quadratic equation where a is equal to 1, b is equal to 6 and c is equal to minus 216. Now using the quadratic formula, let us solve for y. Here our variable is y, so I am writing y. Y is once again equal to minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a. So which is equal to minus b, which is minus 6 plus or minus under root 6 square minus 4 into 1 into 216 divided by 2 into 1. So this is equal to minus 6 plus or minus under root 36, 6 square is 36 and this is minus into minus plus because it is c is minus 216, 4 into 216 which is equal to 864 whole divided by
2. So 864 plus 36 is nothing but 900, and we know that square root of 900 is 30. So this is equal to minus 6 plus or minus 30 by 2. So therefore, separating the roots, we get y is equal to minus 6 plus 30 by 2, and y is equal to minus 6 minus 30 by 2. So here value of y is 30 minus 6, 24. 24 by 2 is 12 meters, and here minus 30 minus 6, which is equal to minus 36 by 2, which is minus 18. So since y is the side of a square, so it cannot be negative. So we discard this solution. So y is equal to 12 meters is our required solution. Y is the side of only one of the squares. Now we need to find the second square. We saw that the another square has a side x meters. So, and we also have the relationship x is equal to 6 plus y. Therefore, x is equal to 6 plus y, which is equal to 6 plus 12, which is equal to 18 meters. So side of one square is 18 meters and side of another square is 12 meters. This is the required solution. This completes your exercise 4.3. In the next class, we'll be learning about the nature of roots. And that's all for today. Thank you.